What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to be going over how to add mods to your Minecraft server. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Vanilla Minecraft is jam-packed with a variety of content to explore and use, but when you're running a server, you might be looking for something to make you stand out. This is where mods come in, which are additions to the Minecraft game that you can add on using your game's files. Adding dangerous mobs, navigating through new dimensions, and finding interesting items is just the surface layer of what can be achieved. This is the perfect way to build your dream server, and with how easy it is to do, you'll wonder why you didn't start sooner. Let's get started. Visit the CurseForge Minecraft Mods page and take the time to find the mod that you want to use. Click on the page and from there, click Files at the top, and then scroll down and click the View All button to see all of the available downloads, and find the version you want and press the Download button to the right. Save the jar file to a separate folder that you can access in just a minute. Now that you have your mods installed onto your computer, you have to upload it to your server. Specific mods might have additional steps, but each of them are going to follow the same general procedure, which is starting with heading to your Apex panel. Stop the server and then scroll down to the game file section and make sure you're running the matching version of Forge or Fabric to the mod that you downloaded. If it's not already, then you're going to use the dropdown to look it up and then choose to change the version and then select I'll restart later. After that, you can head to the FTP file access in the left-hand menu, and then here, find the mods folder and click to enter it. If you don't see a mods folder in your FTP, then you can easily create one by clicking on New Folder in the top left and then naming it Mods. Once you're in that folder, press the Upload button in the top left corner and then drag and drop the mod jar file into the right-hand side. Once they are 100% uploaded, you can use your server name at the top of the page to head back to the main panel where you can restart the server. For some mods, a new world will also have to be created in order for the new changes to take effect. This will most likely be necessary for mods that add new ores, structures, and other world changes. To do this, from the Apex panel, all you have to do is stop the server, and then scroll down to the World section and press the Change World button. Type in a new world name, and then press the green Change World button again for the adjustments to take effect. Finally, restart the server to load up the mod with the new world. Once you've done all of this, your mod is fully installed on the server, but you and any other player wanting to join will most likely have to add these mods on their own client in order to join. We have a super easy to follow guide just like this one that will be linked down below, so make sure to check that out before hopping into your server to play. If the server starts crashing after uploading the mods, there are a few different reasons why this might happen. First, make sure that the mod and the server are running the same version, as well as using the matching mod loader. Fabric mods are not going to work on a Forge server, and vice versa. If you've recently adjusted or removed any mods and the server is stuck loading, this might be due to a missing mod ID in your world. When this happens, the server prevents itself from starting in order to prevent any lost data. This can be bypassed by using the FML confirm command in the server console, or by generating a new world. In some cases, certain mods require additional dependency mods in order to function properly. This is often found either on the mod page itself, or it might be found within the Relations tab at the top of the CurseForge page. To fix this, all you have to do is install that dependency like you do any other mod, and then restart the server. Mods are there to add something in the game that you wouldn't get with vanilla worlds. While they aren't for everyone, it's a great way to add some fun elements to make your server stand out, and with how easy it is to do to your panel, you'll be playing in no time. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.